the equation in slope-intercept form. Y equals mx plus b, where this is what?
And then the y-intercept is b.
And the y-intercept is b. I'm going to say this once, that I am not going to keep telling you that you should be paying attention. If you guys want to make this class very hard to follow, it's up to you. It's not that hard.
It's not hard.
I figured it out.
Oh, right here.
So, what can you tell me? Can you tell me the slope of the y-intercept, Kyle?
-3.
Is?
-3.
What is -3?
The y-intercept.
So we have y equals blah, 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 minus 3, right? Because that's the y-intercept. Right.
Now, you'll have to do y2 minus y1, max 2 minus.
Okay, so y2, let's say that's -2, minus -3 over 3 minus 0. -2 plus 3 is 1. 3 minus 0 is 3. So our slope is?
1/3.
Third. So what is that? How does that make our equation look?
1/3 plus
4,
one third
x minus 3. Sir,
I was hit minus 3.
The y-intercept
is not. How do you know which one it is?
Well,
oh, wait,
is
this the one on the line?
In the equation, look, we're going to write this equation y equals mx plus b.
Yeah.
Let's not lose our understanding and trade it off for shortcuts and memorization. That would be awful. It'll make your life horrible. Do not memorize things. Learn them. We can learn them. Now, this line is a bunch of what?
Points.
Points, a bunch of points. Each point has an x and a y. Here's an interesting x and y. The x is 0. The y is -3. So this is telling me that when I write the equation, if I plug in 0 for x, what will I get?
-3.
And if I'm trying to fill in this equation, I want to make it so that if I plug in 0 here, I wind up with -3. But what's the m times 0?
Zero.
There's nothing left. Right. So somehow I have to take this 0, right, and get -3. How do I get 0? I have a -3.
Oh, -3.
-3. There you go, right? Because the x is 0 and the y is -3, that tells me that x is going to be 0, and well, for y to be -3, I have to have that -3. Is the only option for finding the slope to do this? How else could we find the slope? Sarah?
You could check it on the graph.
Yeah, just look at the graph, right? We know that the slope is the change in y, the change in x. So just between any two points, we just look at the change between those two things. What's the change in x between here and here?
1/3.
3, it changes 3. How much does y change as I go up?
One.
So here we have the horizontal change and the vertical change. You should just put it right in there. Okay. Just look at the graph and count it off. Yes?
I did that, but since it's already on there, I just did the second thing, so I didn't actually show me my work.
So you went straight from this to y equals 1/3 x minus 3?
Yeah, because I did the...
You did this?
Yeah.
But you didn't put little dotted lines or anything?
No. I looked on the book.
On the book. Oh, I looked at the picture in the book. Yeah. And counted it off. Yeah, sure. That seems reasonable to me. Moving on to number 12. Okay, so a boa constrictor. There's something a little bit tricky we have to watch out for here in a second. But it's 18 inches when it's born. How old is it when it's born?
18.
Zero.
18.
Old.
Zero.
Zero. Zero. It is zero. It is no age when it's born. Okay? It breaks out of that egg. It's zero. Then it starts to get older. Okay? So it's 18 inches at zero. All right. Then it grows 8 inches per year. What is this thing?
8 inches.
Oh, rate. It is a rate. If I were to graph this graph, what would the rate translate to on the graph?
Y equals 8x.
So it would be the s?
Oh, it's the slope.
The slope. So this is the rate when we're talking about snake. Mm-hmm. Okay. is the slope, when we're talking about the line, right, translates right over into the equation. And in the equation y equals mx plus b, it translates to m, right?
Mm-hmm.
What does this translate to?
Plus 18.
Yeah, plus 18, because this is 0 years old, zero anything old. It's just not old at all, it's zero. And it just starts at 18, 0, 18. So we would see a plus 18 there. So you would think the equation was y equals 8x plus 18. Except, why is it not? Yes?
Because you're 18 inches after, like, when you do 8 times x, and whenever you plug in for x, then that's when you get 18.
Well, what would we plug in for x to get 18?
Zero.
Zero, so that still works. If you read the problem, though, the problem says, write an equation that represents the length y in feet. Is this in feet?
No.
It's in what?
Inches.
We just need to change all the inches to feet. Mm-hmm. How many feet is 18 inches?
1.6. 1.5.
6 inches more is 1/2 of a foot, right? 1.5 feet. So now the function will work better. It's going to be 1.5 feet at the beginning. Okay. And how many feet is 8 inches?
0.7.
Not half. 6 inches is a half.
Wait, how many? 7 feet left?
0.7.
Not 0.6 either.
8
inches divided by 12 inches per foot
is 0.66.
It is 2/3.
That's the same.
2/3 x plus 1.5. Remember, I am brave. I'm not afraid of fractions. Just write a fraction. I want you to be brave as well. Any questions about the boa constrictor and its equation? Okay. Number 2, 5, and 0, 5. So that's kind of interesting. What's interesting about these 2 points? Aiden?
They both have the same y-intercept.
Both have the same y. Well, not intercept. One of them is the y-intercept, and the other one is another point that has the same y-value. They both have a y-value of 5. So if I were to graph this line, what would it look like? Aiden? Yeah, horizontal, not vertical, right? Horizontal. Same y-value means that all of the points are going to be up here at 5. Okay? So we write y equals mx plus b. Can you tell me either one of these things? The slope or
the
y-intercept?
Is 5.
The y-intercept is 5, as it are all of the other y-values on this line, right? But if I'm just looking at points, just looking at some random points, how do I know that the point I've been given is the y-intercept?
Because the x would be 0.
The x is 0. So I'm doubly sure that this is the y-intercept because x is 0. So we have y equals something, 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 plus 5, the y-intercept. So now we need to know the slope. How are we going to get the slope?
Y minus y1 minus y2 over x1 minus x2.
Okay, so let's call this y1 and x1 and x2 and y2. So we'll do 5 minus 5, 5 minus 5, over 2 minus 0. So we get? 0/2. So what is 0/2?
The slope.
Yes. It's the slope. What number is it equal to?
0.
Okay. 0/2. If I have 0 cookies and I divide them among 2 friends, how much does each friend have?
0.
0. On the other hand, just a side note and a reminder here. If I had 2/0, can I take 2 cookies and divide them among 0 friends?
No.
No. It's
unless it's you. Then yeah, you can.
Well, then you're, let's assume you're your own friend. 2/2, it just doesn't make any sense to divide by 0. Right? So what do we call this when we have something divided by 0? Undefined. All right, so the slope is 0, so the slope is 0. But what's 0 times x?
5.
0 times x is?
Yes.
0. Just like anything times 0 is 0. So we just get y equals 5, does that make sense?
Yeah, because
it doesn't go up or down, it just stays at 5. And these two points are evidence of that, 5. Right, 0, 5, 2, 5, 3, 5, negative 12, 5. All of them are going to have y, 5. And y will always be 5, no matter what x is.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
What?
Ready to write an equation given
yeah.
y-intercept and slope?
Wait.
One, one, three, two.
Just like that?
Like that, or maybe slightly different. I can tell you that in one way or another, like this gave you the slope, right? But it didn't tell you that the slope was 2/5 or 0. It didn't tell you what the slope was. It gave you points, and you had to use a calculator.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
That's
what I
mean. Yeah.
All right.
We'll be similar to that.
Thank you.
Alright, so when we write the equation in slope intercept form, it becomes pretty simple matter of writing the equation that has a slope of negative 4/3 and a y-intercept of 5. So that's the slope and the y-intercept. So y equals, what's our equation?
Negative
4/3
x plus 5.
What she said.
Plus 5, that's perfect. Okay, now here, I'm not telling you that the slope is negative 4/3, but am I telling you what the y-intercept is?
Yeah.
How can you tell I'm telling you what the intercept is, the y-intercept?
Because
x is 0. When x is 0, and I'm thinking about the graph, positive x's are over here, negative x is over here, a 0x is going to be somewhere here. This one is right here. So it's on the y-axis. When x is 0, you know that that is your y-intercept. So we can fill in one part of the equation, right?
-2.
-2.
And then you can put an x automatically.
An x.
And then you gotta take the...
You gotta find the slope.
Yeah, and that equals... 7 over -4.
But if we have a negative divided by negative,
like
positive
7/4.
God dang it, I put a negative, oh maybe I don't know. God, Stuart, I need my paper back.
Is there anything that you could do?
Make
it so that you didn't make those small mistakes.
Only copy this
down, maybe, and slow down.
But I thought I had it.
Also, worry less about interjecting funny things.
Don't get racist, Mr. Stewart.
No, I'm pretty sure I got that right. If I didn't, I'll give you a couple bucks. Cheese.
I'll give you 20 bucks.
A couple bucks.
Are you guys trying to bribe me?
Yeah, what does it look like?
I'll give you a 5 out of 5.
Yeah, it's wrong with that.
All right, so today, what we're going to do, we're going to, well, first, take this. What is this?
The slope
formula, how you find the slope. Given two points, that's how you find the slope of a line. If it's not a line, of course, all bets are off. But if it's a line and you have two points that belong to the line, you do this, y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1, you have the slope. I'm going to use this slope formula to make a new kind of equation for a line. Still be an equation that if you graph all the points, you get a line. It's just a little, like arranged a little differently, used for different situations, Molly.
It doesn't matter if you x1 first or y1 first, right?
If you did y1 first and y2 second, then you do x1 first. Yeah, it doesn't matter. All
right.
What you'll notice is that these two guys clearly come from one point, and these two guys come from
different points.
It just doesn't matter which point. Okay.
Yeah.
So here's what I'm going to do. First, I'm going to multiply this side by x2 minus x1. Which means on the other side, I need to what?
Do this.
Okay. So we'll do that. So what's going to happen on this right side when I multiply this fraction by x cubed minus x1?
It's going to get rid of it.
Alright, they're going to, for to use a term that I do not love, cancel out the x2 minus x1.
Why do you not like that term?
It's so vague. Sometimes cancel means that one thing divides the other and you get 1. Sometimes cancel out means one thing subtracts from another and you get 0. Sometimes cancel out means you take the square root of a square and so you just get the argument back. So, blah. But, okay, it cancels out. What really happens is x2 minus x1, whatever number that is, divides this number. And these would have to be the same number because we use the same number and the same operation to find them. If this is a 5, this is a 5. If this is a 12, this is a 12. And when we divide the number by itself, we get 1. That's what cancels. Okay, so we've done that. We have canceled the x2 minus x1 from the right side. So there is a denominator of 1 now, so really no denominator. We don't need to write it. And on the other side, we just have m times that parentheses. And so there it is, written that way.
If you had numbers in front, I think it would be more easier to understand.
I understand it.
I don't. Things for me.
Then I can understand it. I mean, I'm not bad. Of course, I can understand that. I get what you're saying, and I'm trying to help you in this next example to make it less confusing. All right. Now I'm going to scratch out these twos. Well, if you think about it, when you use the slope equation, it's because you have 2 points, and you're going to find the slope. Right? You got all the numbers you need. You plug in a number there, number there, number there, number there, and they equal a number. But the equation of a line doesn't have all the numbers plugged in. It has an x, right, a variable, and y, a variable. So we're going to forget, like, not make these specific values. We're just going to call them the variable x and y, just like the variable x and y we use in this equation. Right? When we write these equations, we write them with an x and a y, variables. So we have a place to plug in x and a place to get y. We're going to do the same thing here. So now we rewrite it. We rewrite it, and it looks like this. I just put this stuff on the left, that's on the right. Y, this y is a variable. It's a variable. This y is an actual number, right? Where does that number come from?
The problem.
The slope.
The
graph thingies.
The point thingies, yes. The point thingies. This comes from a point. This comes from the same point. The same point as this y came from. Any point you want, just the same one. The same one as this. So these two are actually numbers. These numbers come from the point thingies. This is the variable x, and this is
the slope.
You know, previously we somehow were given the y-intercept and the slope. And so slope-intercept form seems to make sense because in the equation are the slope and the y-intercept. If instead of being given the point that is called the y-intercept, we're just given a random point and the slope, well then the point, we can call it the random point, slope form. Point slope form.
So do you like, once you got this, then would you plug everything in that you know already into there?
Right.
Okay.
So here's an example of that. So let's just interject a little thing here. In conclusion, in developing this equation, we have y, the variable, minus y1, the actual number from a point, equals the slope, times x, the variable, minus x, and x cross the point that this y came from. So here's an example. We have a point 3/4, a slope of 5/3. Here is our point slope form. We don't know what this is. We never know what this is. We never know what the variable y is. We never know what the variable x is. But we do know a couple of things. We have y. What would we do? Y minus what?
3. 4.
4, because we know that this, right, this is y1. This is the y from the point we did it.
Equals
5/3 times
x
the variable
minus 3.
Perfect.
So how would you take 5, so it would be 5/3 x.
So you're doing, what are you doing with 5/3?
That's 3.
Oh, value, or what's this word?
At.
Distributor. Right, we're distributor. Okay, so let's do that. Y minus 4 equals 5 thirds times x. That's just the way it is. What's 5 thirds times a negative 3?
Negative something.
Yeah, positive times negative is negative.
Negative 5.
Yeah, negative 3 times 5 thirds is going to be negative 5. Because 3 divides negative 3, we're left with a negative 1, and there we go, negative 5. So minus 5.
Now then you could do plus 4. I mean,
yep.
Yeah.
Add 4 to both sides. Negative 5 plus 4? Negative 1. 5 thirds x minus 1.
So then you could do plus 1 to the 5 thirds, right? Plus
no, because these are not like terms, right? Apples and oranges here. We're not going to add or subtract anything from the
x. What do we plug into?
Yeah. Now, well, if we want to graph it, then, yeah, then there we go.
Okay.
Are we
going
to have to graph stuff from our homework from that?
No.
We don't.
Apparently.
Okay.
You
don't need to do any inflation.
Alright. So in all these problems on the homework, somehow, I'm spoiling it for you here, somehow you're given the slope, and somehow you're also given the point. Slope.
But can we
go
over
question
number one on the homework?
I'm really confused, Mr. Stewart.
What are you confused about, sir?
Well, like, so if you're converting this back to the other equation.
So this is fine, but then going here is confusing?
Well, I don't get any of it.
What don't you get?
Okay. Wait, so how do you get the 4 there?
Because we're given a point that has an x and a y in it. This y is from this point.
Why is there another y?
Well, that comes from this little thing here. To find the slope, you need 2 points.
Got it.
2 points means 2 y's and 2 x's.
Okay.
And when I multiply both sides by the denominator here, I cancel out there. I get m times the x difference equals the y difference. And then we change the way it looks a little bit. And now this y becomes the variable y, this x becomes the variable x. This x and y are from a point, and this is the slope.
Okay.
Now that sounds all stuff. That's why you have this example.
Can we go over the first question? It does.
Nope.
Right.
Here's this question. So, Declan can devour 9 Cheerios every 5 seconds. After 20 seconds, Declan has consumed 56 Cheerios. I'm going to write an equation representing the number of Cheerios Declan will have eaten after x seconds.
Is that your daughter's name?
It's my son.
Dad, you see
how
long hair?
No.
Cheerios
every 5 seconds. Okay, so, what do we know about the situation? Can we rewrite it kind of in a mathematical, numerical way?
We know that he's already consumed 56 Cheerios.
When has he done that?
In 20 seconds.
So, let's see. What does X represent?
The Cheerios.
Seconds.
Seconds, says, right? Seconds. What does Y represent?
Cheerios.
Right, and that's how this function works. If I give seconds to the function, it should give me back how many Cheerios I've been eating.
Yeah.
Okay, so at 20 seconds, Declan has consumed 56. That's an example of an x and a y.
Right.
The x is 20 seconds, the y is 56 Cheerios.
Who said that? Don't say that again.
That's x seconds, y Cheerios. What else can you tell me about the situation? What do we know? Aiden?
You can devour 9 Cheerios every 5 seconds.
So what does that tell us about the... like an R word?
Right.
The X is 5 and that the Y is 9, but it's telling us... the rate. Yeah, the rate at which you can consume Cheerios. Which to the graph, what do we call it for the graph when we look at
slope.
The slope?
The slope.
Is what the graph... it's how the graph represents the rate. So the rate is 9 what?
9
Cheerios.
Cheer.
To 5 seconds.
Wait, that's how long it takes?
Well, yes. If he takes 5 seconds, he will eat 9 Cheerios. Okay. If he takes 10 seconds, he'll eat 18 Cheerios. If he takes 2.5 seconds, he'll eat
3.6.
3.5. 4.5? 4.5. 4.5. Half the time, half the year. Okay. So we have the and a.
You only eat 36 Cheerios in 20 seconds.
Ratio?
The
point.
A point. I'm sure you did. I missed it. So y minus 56, right? Because that is the y from this point. Equals the slope, 9 fifths, times x minus. X minus what?
Is that supposed to be 36 up there? Because
it is
that
not.
Would be positive.
Oh,
that
would be
stay
nice.
Tuned.
50. 20.
Right, that's the x value. So y minus 56, if you distribute the 9 fifths, like Kyler taught us, we'll get 9 fifths x.
56.
Minus. 9
oh.
fifths times negative 20.
36.
Negative 36.
That's the answer right there.
Then we add 56 to both sides. And what's negative 36 plus 56?
20.
So, what Kyler was saying was, well, in 20 seconds he would consume 36 Cheerios, and he's right. Except, what is this plus 20 tell you?
It's plus 20
seconds. 20 seconds? 20 Cheerios. When?
After we ate that.
When is 20 Cheerios?
In 5 seconds.
What?
Before he even started.
Before he even starts. At 0 seconds, right?
Oh.
0 seconds plus 20. Zero times 9 fifths plus 20. Means he started out having already eaten 20 Cheerios, and then we started watching him eat the Cheerios. So, that's it, and have a good day.
Oh. Hey.